Good morning. We are live from the 2017 Westfield International Air Show, which is going on today for the final day. My name is Elizabeth. I'm a reporter with The Republican and with MassLive.com, and we have been following the show since Thursday when they had a couple of events, and yesterday was the big first air show, and then today is the last air show. So I'm going to walk around with you guys a little bit so you can get a feel for what there is to see, and things will kick off around 10:30 is when the actual aerial acts will begin. There's expected to be 18 aerial acts, which I've been told are phenomenal to watch. The last time that a show was done was in 2010, so it's been 7 years since the last one, and there is a huge crowd here already. It is about, I think, about 9 a.m., and gates opened at 8 o'clock. A couple of things for people who are interested in coming. Beautiful weather, so they're expecting a huge crowd, about 60,000 people, 50 to 60,000 people. So VIP parking is completely full. You cannot order it. So if you look online and it says that there are spots open, there are not. You would have to just come, and there are plenty of free lots. However, they are first come, first serve. So I know for a fact that traffic is already starting to pile up on the pike. And I'm sure local roads are going to get pretty crowded too. Definitely worth coming to the show though if you have the time today. It starts at about 10:30. It'll be going till about 5 o'clock. So even if you miss some of the early aerial acts, you'll be able to catch some in the afternoon. And all of them are spectacular. Let's see, what else is there besides the aerial shows? As you can see here, we're looking at some vintage planes. There are about a dozen or even more vintage World War I, World War II planes on display. And what's really cool is that you can actually talk to people who are historians, pilots, military staff, people who really love these planes, who know a lot about them and are happy to share information. The vice commander here said that everyone is willing to talk. If you have questions, they want to answer your questions. They want you to come out with your family. This is definitely a family-friendly event. It is free. Which is probably why there's such a huge crowd that's going to gather here today. If you cannot make it and you want to at least hear the show, they're not live streaming, but on 89.5 FM, you can catch the show that way. They're going to be doing all the audio, so you'll be able to hear what's going on. And if you live around the area, you'll probably see some of the planes flying around near you. So some things that are important just for housekeeping, if you're on your way, you can only bring sealed water, juice, Gatorade, no alcohol, and no open containers. They will not let you in with open bottles of water, open juice. Really important, they don't want people smoking here because it's super dangerous with all the fuel in the planes. So no smoking, no open bottles, no alcohol, no pets unless it's a service animal. We're gonna stop here and look at this plane because it's pretty cool. Let's see, you can bring lawn chairs, you can bring umbrellas, things like that, but no like beach umbrellas, standing umbrellas, nothing that would be too distracting for other people to be able to sit in the crowd and watch. And what else? I think that's pretty much it. I'm probably going to repeat this again just as some of you are just joining us. We are at the 2017 Westfield International Air Show at Barnes 104th Fighter Wing. The gates are now open. They opened at 8 o'clock. The show will kick off around 10:30 to 11, depending on the weather, and it'll be going till about 5 o'clock tonight. So you might have to wait in traffic a little bit, but there's plenty of shows all afternoon, so it's not like you're going to miss everything if you show up a little bit later. The event is free. It's open to the public. There is free parking. However, it is first come, first serve. So, you know, if you're interested in coming, I would say hop in your car right about now and get on the road. It's a really exciting show. There's about 18 aerial acts throughout the day. And even cooler, I think, is that you can see vintage planes up close. So as you can see right now, we're walking towards a few of them. There's more than a dozen vintage planes, World War I, World War II planes, restored in perfect condition. And there's pilots here. There's a lot of military staff that are familiar with the planes. They're here to talk to you about them. They welcome questions. They want people to take pictures. Feel free to bring your cameras. It's just a really cool event, and it's kind of an amazing opportunity for people to come and have a family event that's free, and right here in our community, right here in Westfield. So let's see. This is a pretty cool plane. They've got some vendors. There's some food vendors. It's okay to bring beverages, but nothing open. So you can bring water, Gatorade, juice. Everything just has to be sealed. They will check your car when you get it onto the base. They don't want any alcohol. They absolutely want no smoking. That's a big one. They really don't want people smoking here because it's, you know, it's dangerous because of the planes and the fuel, and there's a lot of kids on campus here today. So if you can't come to the show, like I mentioned before, 89.5 FM, once the actual aerial shows begin at about 10:30, they'll start broadcasting live. Unfortunately, there isn't a live stream, which kind of sucks, but I will be hopping back up on Mass Live's Facebook page to do as much as I can once the show begins. They are expecting a crowd of about 60,000 people, so I don't know how reception will be, but I'm definitely going to try and show you guys some of the aerial acts as they come up, because I think they're going to be pretty spectacular. And yeah, I think that's it for now. We're just walking on the look at the Thunderbirds. That's kind of what everybody looks forward to. It's the closing performance of the night, and that'll be closer to the 5 p.m. mark. And I don't know how well you guys can see them with the sun here, but we're gonna get as close as we can. As you can see, people have already put their lawn chairs, and there's already a big crowd, and it's only 9 a.m. And the show doesn't start for about another hour and a half. So you still definitely have time to get here. I would encourage you, if you're free and your family's free, to come and hang out. It's a free event right here in Westfield. Traffic is a little rough, but they're doing a really good job with parking and getting everybody seamlessly in and out. So you might have to wait a little bit, but I'm told the show's fabulous. I'm very excited to see all of the aerial acts. I know we have a wing walker that's gonna be doing a performance, and that should be pretty amazing, I think. So here are the Thunderbirds. I think you can see them from here. If you're just joining us, we're on the Barnes 104th Fighter Wing base. We are here for the 2017 Westfield International Air Show. The last time the show was done was 2010. So it's pretty special that they're here again and that they're offering the show for free for families to come out and see these magnificent planes in action. So there are some Thunderbirds. They will be closing out the show. That'll be around 5 o'clock tonight. Show kicks off at around 10:30 to 11. That's what the staff was saying. Depends on the weather. And the acts, obviously all the aerial acts are dependent on how the weather is at that time, because, you know, they don't want to put anybody in a dangerous situation. So it's just really exciting. It's so cool that this event is happening here for our community and that it's free. Parking is free. All the VIP lots are full. So even if you go online to get information about the show and it says that they're available, they are not. They told us that those are all full, so you would have to go to one of the free lots. They've got plenty of them. It's just a matter of, you know, waiting in line basically to get in. But 18 aerial acts spread out between 10:30 and 5 o'clock tonight, so there's definitely a chance to see some really cool planes and some amazing skilled pilots in action. There are a bunch of vintage planes as well, as I mentioned before. You can see planes from World War I, World War II, and they're restored and looking just as if they had been built yesterday, which is pretty fantastic. Oh, all right, someone mentioned here, Thunderbird number 5, Alex Turner, is from Chelmsford. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, but from Massachusetts. That's really cool. I'm excited to see the Thunderbird show. Facebook, Mass Live's Facebook page, we will be streaming live once the show starts at about 10:30. And as it depends on reception, obviously there's going to be thousands and thousands of people here, so I'm going to do my best to get you guys some visual of the show if you can't make it here. If you want to hear audio of the show, 89.5 FM will be broadcasting live audio of the show. I'm not sure about motorcycle parking. If you just type in Google Westfield International Air Show 2017, it'll take you right to their page, and there's information on parking there. Also, masslive.com, on the main page right now, there's a story that just says, you know, what you need to know about the air show, and I believe there's information there as well. So yeah, this is a vintage plane. There's a bunch of them on display, and as you can see, they're restored beautifully. They're worth looking at, just if you want to learn more about, you know, planes or the history. I would be happy to interview him. I can ask about that. I would love to interview someone who's flying a Thunderbird. That would be pretty cool. If you're just joining us, 2017 Westfield International Air Show. This is the last day of the show. There was a full day yesterday, and there was a couple events on Thursday and Friday as well. But this is the last day of the show, kicking off at about 10:30, and it'll go till about 5 o'clock tonight. Start flight, I believe they're saying between 10:30 and 11. They don't give precise times for anything, simply because it just depends on what the weather is doing at that exact moment. So they think between 10:30 and 11. I'm going to try and go live at that time to let people know what's going on and show as much of the show as I can stream. They're expecting about 50 to 60,000 people, though, so reception might be an issue. Definitely still worth coming out to, even if you do have to wait a little bit in traffic. They're trying to do a good job of keeping it super organized and keeping it, you know, flowing as best as possible. Hi, Elizabeth. Thank you for joining. Appreciate you guys watching. This is such an incredible event. It's totally family friendly. It's free to the public. Again, just housekeeping things. Don't bring open bottles. They won't let them in. You can bring sealed juice, water bottles. You can bring in, you know, Gatorade, stuff like that. It all has to be factory sealed. They will be checking cars for that. You can bring lawn chairs and folding chairs, but they don't want any big standing umbrellas or pop-up tents or anything that could obscure the view, because it's going to get really crowded and they want as many people as possible to be comfortable and to be able to enjoy it. No smoking. That's a really big one. They want us to remind you guys, please just refrain from smoking. It is a family event. There's a lot of kids here. There's also a lot of planes with a lot of fuel. So they just want to be careful. Oh, watching from Puerto Rico. That's excellent. There are definitely some Puerto Rican airmen on the base. I've spoken to a bunch of people today. That's one of the cool things about the show. The staff is on hand to talk to people about the planes, about the history of the base, about the performances that the aerial acts that they're going to see today. So there's a really good opportunity to interact with all of the people that work here every day that are, you know, looking out for us as a whole and our military and making sure that we are safe. And yeah, you get to meet them. Really great event for kids, especially if they're interested in, you know, World War One or World War Two, or in planes, or seems like there's some vintage cars too. There's just an opportunity to do a lot of really cool stuff. And again, kicks off at about 10:30. I am gonna sign off for now. I will be back on as soon as the first flight starts, and we'll try and live stream as much of it as we can. Again, reception is probably going to be an issue, but I'm going to try my best. So thank you all for watching. I hope that you take an opportunity to drive out here with your family if you're in the area. If not, please be sure to check masslive.com. We have tons of coverage. Our photographer Fred Gore has taken amazing photos of the show yesterday. He'll be doing a huge gallery of photos again today. We have obviously Facebook live streaming from yesterday. We have videos of interviews with the Vice Commander and some of the other people here on the base. It's going to be a great day. So if you have an opportunity to come, be sure to do so. And if you can't, then check us out on Mass Live, and we'll have as much coverage as we can. Thank you.